Yep, I know. The Bitwig 2.2 update has come out, and with it, some new devices and new mods. And so that is what we're going to talk about in this here tutorial, and probably a couple that follow this one. One of the new mods that I'm most excited about is called Audio Rate, and I'm going to show you why that thing is cool right now. Let's start the show! Okay, so just to bring you up to speed, what I've done is I've gone into my Earth Moments pack here. I grabbed some other Indian sounding lady, as I often do, and this is what she sounds like. Yep. Okay, so I think the best way for me to show you what Audio Rate actually does is to first create a new empty track. And I'm actually going to mute this guy. And then I'm going to put in a DC offset. You'll see why in a second. If you watch my other tutorials, you'll know that if you modulate this thing, you can actually get a sound. If I were to wiggle this fast enough, I would get a sound, right? If you leave it in the center, there is no sound. Hence the master. You can see when I turn it up, the master goes up. Even when I turn it down, the master goes up. So using that, I'm going to add in this new device, or I guess, sorry, new mod, Audio Rate. Plug it in there. Okay, and I'm going to click the mod button and modulate this all the way down. Right. And I'm going to choose the input of this lady. And I chose pre because I have it muted. So right now, if I don't have this on, listen, nothing. You don't hear anything, okay? But if I turn this on, exactly, because what this Audio Rate is doing is just taking the signal from this lady singing and using it basically as an LFO, right? So instead of me assigning an LFO to this thing and getting a single tone, it's taking a complex waveform and just following it and using that waveform to modulate this up and down. And that's why you get an exact replica. That's not really fun. That's not fun enough. All I've done really is duplicate the sound. So one other thing that you can do, however, is you can mix in an LFO to this guy. And we'll take this and we'll modulate it. And let's just see. This is going to be annoying for a sec. Okay, just hold on. Okay. All right, let's have a listen. Take complex waves, mix them with simple waves. I gotta turn this thing off here. Inactive. And basically, yeah. So if I wanted to not use it on a DC offset, for example, maybe I'll take another sample. Let's see what else do we have here. It's our buddy. Let's take him. Slap him in there. Okay, so now maybe we want to throw a device on there. Maybe we'll use the new time shift tool. And we'll time shift him based on the audio rate of the lady singing. So let's have a go. I don't know what this is going to sound like. It's probably really terrible. Oh. Whoa, you can't mod the time shift. That's a bummer. For real? Let me see. That can't be right. Yeah, you can't. Oh, wait. First of all, I got to put that in raw mode. Well, that's a bummer. I wonder if I put it in samples. Can I mod it now? No. You're not allowed. LFO. Nope. So you're not allowed to modify this guy, the time shifter, which is a huge buzzkill. Well, I guess I can show you why the time shifter is cool. But first, I want to find something to mod. That's a huge buzzkill. Wow. I don't know. Let's just take a filter for now. Throw audio rate on there. modulate the frequency. You know what? Let's start it up higher. Do that.
Gadi lo nar dube maro re wo be bado re ja jariya. Gadi lo nar dube maro re wo be bado re ja jariya.
Wait, forgot.
Gadi lo nar dube maro re wo be bado re ja jariya. Gadi lo nar
dube maro re wo be bado. Well, that's weird and unpleasant, but hey, there's something to that. Okay. Oh, well, now that we're all buzzkilled and sad and we're going to lament the loss of our ability to mod things, let's see why the time shift is cool. All right, let's take this, for example. All right, let's put it in raw mode. Duplicate it out and zoom way the hell in. I'll go to the start and then zoom in. Okay. So now you have to think for a sec, okay? I don't want to make you think, but it's kind of necessary. Because we have a duplicated signal, what we're looking at right now is a signal that's exactly in phase, okay? Because when this wave goes above the zero line, this wave goes above the zero line, and so on and so forth. Now, if you're actually recording a mandolin, is it a mandolin? Yeah, if you're actually recording a mandolin, you might have two different microphones placed in two separate spots on the mandolin. One probably facing the neck, the other one somewhere around the body. But the thing, and that gives you a good sound, but the problem is the sound is arriving at those microphones at slightly different times. So for example, if I go like this, it could be like that. Okay, just a little bit out. And now it's out of phase. If it was completely out of phase, it would be something like this. And that means when this one is up, this one's going down, and they cancel each other out in a weird way. So let's hear what it sounds like originally. Put that on loop. Right? Where's that even playing from? Yeah. Okay, so now let's put them both together. Now that one is a little bit out of phase. Hear the difference? Nice and rich, weird and tinny. So what you could do is, where am I here? Let's go back to the start. What you could do is delay one signal or just shift it in time. So if this one is maybe not quite that far out of phase, but even just like that, makes a huge difference, right? Well, on this one, you could add a time shift tool. Do-ba-do-do, time shifter. Where are you? Right there. And we could bring it ahead. Or let me think. Yeah, we'll be bringing it ahead. Yes, right. So let's have a listen. Right? I know. So you can basically fix little phase issues. The only thing is that you don't get to see it in real time, which is kind of a bummer. Like, it'd be nice if as you did that, it was bringing this frontwards and backwards. But what the hell? You can't have everything, right? So I guess that's one of the many uses. It really, really sucks that you can't mod this. And I'm not sure why that is. I think it's because you would freak out your delay compensation. This means delay compensation is basically kicked in. And that's why you can't mod it. I wonder, Can I turn off my delay compensation? Plug in delay compensation. Okay, so if I turn that off now, can I mod it, please? Bitwig, please? Let's just take an LFO for now. Ah, you miserable prick. Nope. So basically, Bitwig 2.2 came out and buzz killed us all. But one cool thing is that that audio, whatchamacallit? Ah, what's it called again? Ah, damn it. The audio rate. And that's pretty cool. You can get pretty serious with that sucker. And yeah, so you should do that. So basically, in a nutshell, the audio rate just takes whatever signal that you are putting in here, right? And using that signal as an LFO. So you can do weird things. Like, for example, this. Because everyone wants that sound in their life, right? Okay, kids, next up. Actually, I don't know yet, so you'll just, I guess you'll see when we get there. All right? Okay. All right. Take care.